championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Magic Johnson with some comments that we need to discuss, predicting the future of Kyle Kuzma, and I think he is on the money here, as well as talking about some changes the Lakers need to make this offseason. Make sure you do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell. And if you don't know already, we've started up the NBA Front Office YouTube channel, which you should definitely go check out and subscribe to. Keith Smith and I, in just a little bit, are going to be putting out a video all about some NBA rule changes and the players they are going to be impacting for next season. So make sure you guys go check that out as well. Joining me is Ron Gutterman from LakersNation.com. Ron, how are you doing, man? And we've got some Magic Johnson comments to dig into. Gotta love that.
Yeah, it seems like every couple of months or so, Magic Johnson makes his rounds on network TV and radio and all this stuff, and he always ends up just talking a little bit too much, saying a little bit more than he probably should, and it leads to some great comments for us. You know, it leads to some good stuff.
Well, so Magic Johnson, like you said, he tends to pop up every so often, and a lot of the things that he can say, they're pretty hyperbolic, right? He says stuff where he goes a little too far, and that's part of the reason why he struggled when he was running the Lakers, because he likes to talk, and it's hard to have that job and like to talk a lot. You can get yourself into a bit of trouble, which he certainly did, but Magic's comments this time around, I can't just brush them off as Magic being Magic, because while maybe he went too far, they do have the ring of truth to them. Here's what he said about Kyle Kuzma. This is what jumped out at me first, and it was almost just kind of an aside, just thrown in to what he was saying over on ESPN on the KJZ show. Magic said that Kyle Kuzma is checking out. Here's what he said. I know Kuzma right now. He's already checked out, saying, hey, he's going to be traded. So we'll see what happens there. That's interesting to me that he's making that comment about Kyle Kuzma. And again, it's got the ring of truth because, number one, I've been saying this for weeks now, logistically, purely from a logistics sense, Kyle Kuzma's contract this next season is much easier to trade at $13 million. And in fact, if the Lakers are going to make any big move on the trade market, you almost have to use Kuzma's contract. It's going to be a really important piece to any trade. And then you add in that Kyle Kuzma removed references to the Lakers from his Instagram bio. So, Ron, what are your thoughts on this? Is Magic spilling the beans here? I mean, we know he's got a direct line to Jeannie Buss. How do you take this?
I mean, normally it's very easy to just chalk it up to Magic being Magic and talking. Mm-hmm. But not only does he have a direct line to Jeannie Buss, he also developed quite a rapport with Kyle Kuzma because of their similar backgrounds.
Yes.
So he and Kuzma were very close during his tenure with the Lakers, and I wouldn't be surprised if this is coming either from Jeannie Buss or directly from Kuzma himself. I wouldn't be surprised if there were kind of some open conversations there, just because Jeannie and Magic are so close, Kuzma and Magic are so close, that there seems to be a ring of truth to this. And it's not just out of nowhere. We have been talking about this for several weeks now, that if Kuzma's ever going to get traded, it's probably now. It's probably before this next season starts. So I'm surprised he said it so boldly, which, that's the Magic thing, but I'm surprised he said it so boldly, but there is some truth to it. There's got to be.
It was very, the way he said it was just very matter of fact. Like, yeah, he's getting traded. I mean, even for Magic Johnson, it was a surprise that he was just that forthcoming with it. Like, oh yeah, it's obvious. This is going to happen. So last night we did a Lakers Nation offseason live show, and a lot of people were asking us about Kyle Kuzma, and I said I was at about 40-ish percent that he gets traded, 60% that he doesn't, and that was purely because NBA trades are hard to negotiate. I've got to push that up a little bit and say that most likely he's going to be dealt. I'm going to say that it's a greater than 50% chance now that he does get traded.
Yeah, I mean, and yesterday I was quite the pessimist. I said it was a 75% chance he gets traded. And now I'm probably around 80. I don't see a world in which Magic Johnson's going on TV and saying Kyle Kuzma's, like, the way Magic Johnson said it, it's like a foregone conclusion. Mm-hmm. They've already picked the trade. They're just waiting to announce. Like, that's how it felt, because it was so casual. It was so matter of fact. It almost felt like oh, Jeannie Buss already has the deal she wants. She's just waiting. And it's one of those things, like, you wouldn't expect it, but at a certain point, Kuzma was probably going to get traded just because it's always been an awkward fit alongside LeBron James and a little bit alongside Anthony Davis. So you felt like it had to be coming at a certain point.
And him saying he's already checked out, like that obviously is backed up by Kuzma's action of removing Lakers from his Instagram account. And I tend to not buy into that stuff, right? A player removing a team or whatever, or who they follow on Instagram, I tend to not worry about that stuff too much. But when it's backed up here by Magic saying he's checked out, and then you see that, okay, he removed Lakers, I mean, where there's smoke, there's fire. I feel fairly confident now that I think we are going to see Kyle Kuzma actually get moved. Now, again, never... Look, things change very quickly in the NBA, so there's nothing that's a lock, but it does feel very likely now that Kuzma will be on the move.
Yeah, I definitely still think Ben Simmons is more likely to get traded than Kyle Kuzma, but the gap isn't quite as big as I thought when the offseason started for the Lakers. I just think that Kuzma, I think he knows it. If Magic's saying that he knows it, he must know it. The time has probably come here. And yeah, Magic just going on national television and just outwardly saying, yeah, he's checked out, he's on his way out, it's so only a matter of time here. Like, it just feels so like the deal's already done. I don't know. It feels so strange to say that.
Now, Magic saying this, does this diminish the Lakers' bargaining power in trade discussions? For me, I feel like because it's Magic, it kind of, you know, it gets taken with a grain of salt. So I don't think it's not, certainly not as damaging as like if Rob Pelinka came out and said it, or like, you know, I don't know, if Doc Rivers came out and made some negative comments about Ben Simmons. Like, that's probably more damaging to a player's trade value than Magic saying this. But do you think this does put the Lakers in a more difficult position leverage-wise?
No, I think Magic Johnson comments are along the same lines of, like, Stephen A. Smith saying he got a text that this is going to happen. It's along those lines where it's like, okay, maybe, but we're erring on the side of you're saying nothing that actually matters, because that's what they usually do, right? Like, Magic Johnson usually just talks and talks and talks until eventually a combination of words come out that gets a headline. So this is just what Magic does. I just think, I don't think it affects his value at all. I just think there's maybe some truth to what he's saying.
Yeah, and again, we tend to take Magic Johnson's comments, and we still should, with a grain of salt, because he does like to just talk, right? And of course, he's got inside knowledge and all that. But again, what he's saying here lines up with everything else that we've been putting together, everything else that we've been seeing happen, and so it does feel like it's got the grain of truth here. Now, Magic also had some comments about the Lakers and how much their roster needs change, right? And he said, and this is what I've seen from a lot of Lakers fans around the country right now, is people saying, look at all the other teams that are still playing. Look at the teams who are getting role players to step up, right? You've got Cameron Payne. You've got Kevin Huerter with the Hawks that is making big plays over there. You've got these guys on teams that are stepping up, and then thinking the Lakers, they didn't really have anybody step up like that. And Magic made that comment as well. He said, because you had an opportunity there with Anthony Davis getting hurt, with LeBron James not being 100%, there was an opportunity for Kyle Kuzma to step up, Marc Gasol to step up, Dennis Schroeder to step up, on and on and on. And he said, and he did, and they didn't. They just didn't. These guys did not step up when the Lakers needed them to, and so therefore, there has to be changes this offseason. Is that going to be Rob Pelinka's mentality? I know he was a lot more cautious in the exit interview, talking about how they feel like they've got a championship squad. But Magic's not wrong here either.
You know, I actually tend to side more with Rob Pelinka on this, mm-hmm. just because role players are role players. They're not always going to step up. I mean, last year, the 2020 season, the same role players, KCP, Alex Caruso, they stepped up in a big way. They were phenomenal during the playoffs, both of them. So it's not the reason that the Lakers role players failed to live up to expectations is not because of poor roster construction or bad coaching or anything. It's just simply they were in a cold streak, and all of them happened to be in a cold streak at the exact same time. Injuries didn't help. A lot of stuff there, but I don't think it's the fault of roster construction. So I think, yes, there are obviously changes that could be made. I'm not saying the roster's perfect, But I'm saying role players not stepping up is not the fault of bad roster construction and is a sign of things that need to be changed.
I think we need to look at it as, you know, we see what Cameron Payne has done in Phoenix. We see what Kevin Huerter has done with Atlanta. We see what a number of different players have done, stepping up their games. We need to remember that that's not the norm, right? It's certainly helpful, and it's certainly something that you need, but most role players don't step up, and that's what makes them role players. If they step up all the time, they're not role players anymore, right? So I don't know that we can look at this and just say, oh, these guys just don't have value anymore. The Lakers need to make massive changes. I think it's more of a few tweaks here and there, but I think Magic did a nice job of voicing the concerns of Lakers fans, though, seeing other teams have role players step up when it felt like the Lakers guys, for the most part, kind of shied away from the moment.
Yeah, and look, that's what Magic Johnson is great for. He is an ambassador. He is a mouthpiece for the fans. He's not a very good mouthpiece for the organization. And we saw that when he was the president of the organization. He does not do a good job of translating what's happening on the court to moves that they need to make off the court. Simply because he's a fan. That's what he is. He reacts boldly. He says, oh, we don't have three-point shooting? Cool, I'm trading Ivica Zubac for Mike Muscala because he has a higher three-point percentage. I'm trading Svi Mykhailiuk for Reggie Bullock because he has a higher three-point percentage. Like, this is who Magic Johnson is. He sees what's happening on the court, and he reacts boldly. And that's not good, but it's great when you're speaking on behalf of fans.
Ron, you're making me relive those moves right now, and it's so painful.
Horrible.
It's so painful.
So bad. Just a terrible, terrible front office decision maker, but a great ambassador for the fans.
In any event, interesting stuff from Magic Johnson revealing, and it does sound like Kyle Kuzma may indeed be on the move. Lakers fans, give us your thoughts in the comments down below. What kind of a trade would you like to see Kyle Kuzma involved in, and do you think he is indeed on his way out the door? Don't forget to subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, see ya and stay safe.